Hi, my name's Tracy McBurney, and I'm the author of I'm Coming Home Messy. People have asked me, how did you get here? You, the self-proclaimed technophobe, has written a book on spiritual technology and super technology. How could this possibly have happened? I gotta say, God knows. So here we are. I've asked myself that question too. I've said, what were the forces that were in place that got my thinking to the place where I would be here? And so as I think back, I have to think of two important events. One, sitting in the presence of Dr. Art Martin. He made me consciously aware of the idea that we operated in our minds like computers. It was fascinating to sit with him and to learn his classes, hour after hour, as he went through all of the different layers of our minds and all of the different operating systems that could be haywire and corrupted inside of our beings. It was a wonderful, wonderful journey of learning with him. At some point in those years, I picked up a book that I think was partially channeled and some historical, called Anna, Grandmother of Jesus, written by a woman named Claire Hartsong. I had never thought, when I picked up this book, that Jesus even had a grandmother. I'd never gone to those levels of thinking. This book was interesting. I didn't read all of it. I read parts of it. But there were periodically references to technologies that were being learned in the mystery schools at that time, when she was alive. And I remember thinking even then, what an interesting way that this woman had put it, technologies. That within these mystery schools all those years ago, there were people studying mystical rules and processes, and she was calling them technologies. I remember being very interested in that. And so I think somewhere between Art Martin and this book, I came to this idea that I wanted to know more. I wanted to know about some of those technologies, not necessarily the ones that she was alluding to in this book, but I wanted to learn about the truth of that within us. Could this possibly be what some of these ascended masters had meant when they alluded to us that which they showed us was there for us to have and it was within us as well? Could they have been talking about these technologies? So I think that's really where it began. That's where my curiosity began. That's where this passion started to bubble up to understand more about what that is. And I do think there's more to come, because I actually think this is only the beginning, the little chip of the iceberg that I've delivered to you in this book. One of the most exciting technologies brought forward in this book happens in one of the later chapters. I call it uploading and downloading with your divine intelligence. And it truly is like nothing that I have ever felt or experienced, and my clients would agree. This is a technology that uses no words. It is activated through intention and a desire to share with this divine intelligence within each of us, and a desire to receive information back from this divine intelligence, as well as healing when required. This was difficult for me to do in written form within this chapter in this book, so I decided very early on to make an audio module that would be a companion for this portion of the text, and that is available on iTunes. I truly felt it was important that people be walked through this process from an audio perspective, so that they could really be involved in their psychic capacity to be able to download and upload what that felt and what that sensed like to them, truly honoring who they were and how they did that within themselves, because it appears that this process is unique for each of us. There are many other technologies that are delivered within this book, and it is my desire that it would be read, that people would find it, that they'd wish to experience it, that they'd get curious, and that from experiencing it,